I need you to quote me a scholar that says all of the earliest sources are the most reliable. We know this is false through the method of jarh wa ta'dil. Have you studied jarh wa ta'dil?
You haven't studied any scholar.
Now I'm going to flip it onto you. If you go to 2 Corinthians 12, 17, Paul was tortured by Satan. Why was Paul tortured by Satan?
The Bani Israel that lived with the Arabs, this God is not a pagan God.
Okay, can you let me speak? The Bani Israel that lived with the Arabs, the Israelites that lived in Arab lands, yes, they used the words.
They never used.
Yes, they
no,
did.
No, 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 no.
Yes, they did.
always worship Yahweh God all the time.
Of course, after they were exiled, they were spread across the world, yes? And they forgot their language, yes? Okay, some of them spoke Greek, they forgot Hebrew. Some of them spoke Arabic, they forgot Hebrew.
Arabic has never been spoken in Israel, and they use the word Allah for God, but it's not much about the word, as I said before, it's about the belief.
I'm saying the belief is distinct. You're tying the word Allah into something that's pagan. That's not true.
No, your Quran is doing this.
No,
because Surah 53 verse 19 and 20 clearly says that Allah has three daughters.
No.
Allah has three daughters, Lat, Manat, and Uzzat. Three daughters.
No, the Quran is Allah. What they believe. That's what the Quran is quoting. What they believe.
If that's not
who believe?
Why did Muhammad follow and worship?
Quran is saying they believe. Who they? Forefather. Muhammad's forefather.
You don't even let me speak.
Muhammad's forefather.
Yes, I let her speak. She's not letting me speak.
That doesn't make one God. Because that in the Quran is saying, woe to them who believe that he takes
people. Exactly.
The question is, why did Muhammad bow down to them? If it is wrong, why did Muhammad bow down to them?
If it is war, then why Muhammad accepted it? And why Muhammad worshipped with pagan?
Let's see. I'm just going to speak. She talked about the incident of Gharani. This incident, by the consensus of the scholars, is a fabricator. And I can quote to you scholars that say this.
So now you are like other Muslims. You are hiding behind these scholars.
Who says it's fabricated?
Yeah.
So give us the story behind the scholars, behind Hadith. Why do you believe that it has been fabricated, and who are those names? Okay, no, give us from the beginning.
No, so, Aslan, this incident in the beginning, this is how allegedly the story goes. I'm going to narrate how allegedly it is. Now, allegedly, the Prophet had Surah 53 being revealed to him. While it was being revealed to him, Satan came in and he cast some own verses in there. Then when this happened, they all allegedly worshipped the idols. Allat and Uzza and Manat and all of this stuff.
So
then, hold on. Then allegedly afterwards he said, oh, these are satanic verses. This is the incident of
Quran.
Allegedly the Prophet said these are satanic verses.
Yeah?
Allegedly, okay. But I can quote you back.
Okay.
You good?
Allah's Prophet, listen carefully. So Allah's Prophet opened his mouth so that Satan can put false revelation in his mouth.
Exactly, yes.
So instead of closing his mouth tightly so that Satan cannot put his word in his mouth, he just left his mouth open so that Satan can work on his heart as well as on his mouth, as well as on his body, as well as on his action.
Okay. Okay. No can I respond to that?
Let him make his point and then we respond. Yeah. So far, we confirm that he acknowledges that true or false, that Satan is involved Muhammad to recite those verses.
No, I acknowledge that. I'm going to make it again in case you wasn't
listening.
I'm going to make it again.
You are going to make a case that actually that story is not true. So that's what you believe. So give us the sources.
First, I'm going to quote to you first. No problem.
So don't hide behind
Now the source correct me if I'm wrong.
Hadith is
more
saying
than one. There's more than
these
one.
Are false.
The one that
these
I
are
looked at is Ibn Ishaq. That was the source. طيب. Now I'm going to quote to you Ibn Kathir's opinion on this. He said that this incident, which is called Gharanit, this is the nickname of this incident, is Mursal, which means it's disconnected, and the chain is inauthentic. And
so who are those in chains that they are not authentic? Give us the name of the people
so
in the chain.
So this is alleged chain. Lay had narrated from Ibn Shibab al-Zuhri. Then he narrated from Abu Bakr Ibn Abdul Rahman, and then he narrated from Harith Ibn Hisham.
So
and this is recorded in Ibn Ishaq.
Who says that? Ibn Kathir says that.
No, Ibn Kathir, wait, I'm going to give you the reference first. So in Ibn Kathir's commentary, the tafsir, on Surah Al-Najm, chapter 53, verses 19 and 20, he said, and I'm going to quote you, wait one second. But he generally, I gave you the reference anyways, chapter 53, verse 19 and 20, he says this incident is Mursal. Now we're going to go to Al-Qurtubi's position on this. In his tafsir on Surah Hajj, and I'm going to give the page, ayah 25, in his tafsir Al-Qurtubi, page 424, he says, I'm going to quote, it is not enough that this narration is mentioned by anyone from the people of authenticity, and it is not narrated with any reliable connected chain of narration. I'll repeat the reference. Al-Tafsir Al-Qurtubi, page 427. In his Tafsir of Surah Hajj, verse 25. And I have Ar-Razi stuff. Now I'm going to flip it onto you. If you go to 2 Corinthians 12:17, Paul was tortured by Satan. Why was Paul tortured by Satan?
Let me
2 Corinthians chapter 12 verse 7.
Let me respond.
He was tormented by a messenger of
Satan. Listen. So, Surah, satanic verses. Listen what I'm reading very carefully. And then we will acknowledge that Muhammad, whom is supposed to be the man of Allah, doesn't even recognize the word of Satan versus word of angel.
Yeah.
He doesn't even know
he
what
couldn't
is the
recognize.
Voice of Satan looks like. I am going to give you two sources, and I am sure those sources will already butcher your scholars. One of the earliest biographies, this is what it states. Then God sent down by the stars when it says your compare errs, or it is not deceived. He speaks not from his own desire. And when he reached these words, have you told Al-Alat, Al-Uzra, Manat, the third, the other? Satan was meditating upon it and desiring to bring it to his people. Put upon his tongue. There are exalt Numadan cranes whose intercessors are approved. Then Gabriel came to Apostle and then said, what have you done, Muhammad? Have you read those? Are you listening?
Yeah, I'm listening.
Can you repeat
the
last? Can you
listen? You said, what have you done, Muhammad? And then you stopped.
Yes, thank you for listening. What have you done, Muhammad? You have read to those some things I did not bring to you from God. You have said what he did not say to you. The apostle was bitterly grieved and was greatly fear of God. So God sent them, for he was merciful to him, confronting him and making light of the affair. And telling him that every prophet and apostle before him desire as he desired and wanted what he wanted. And Satan interjects something onto his desire as he had done on his tongue. So God emulated what Satan has suggested and what God established in this verse. This is Ibn Ishaq.
Yeah.
Now, he is the best scholar to you, Tabari, alongside of Muhammad and Umar. Listen this very carefully. I believe
Tabari.
You believe Muhammad and Umar is your good scholars?
Do you mean Muhammad ibn Abdullah? Which one?
Muhammad is the bad prophet.
Oh, do you mean the prophet Muhammad? Okay.
Revelation?
I think 1217. Let me check.
The revelation.
Yes, it is. Let me check.
Sir?
Yeah?
Now I'm just going to give him the verse. You can continue talking about it.
The revelation reason for the verse.
Yeah, it is. 2 Corinthians 12:7. 12:7. Here all the
reason for the reason for revelation of this verse.
Yeah.
I've got the full here. This is Tabari 6:107. I'm not gonna read the full. If you want, I can do that. So the part I'm focusing is, okay, my question was to you originally, if Muhammad didn't follow all those gods, why did he bow down and worship this pagan god?
Yeah,
okay?
Yeah, that's the main question.
I haven't finished yet, sir. The Quraysh then despaired, it used to be written from here. All Muslims follow. Okay.
Yeah.
They were very pleased. The messenger of Allah,
yeah.
Allah bless him and give him peace,
yeah.
Carried on reciting until the end of surah,
yeah.
And then
yeah.
Consecrated.
Yes. All Muslims.
Recited all the surah.
Yes.
And
yes.
And all the Muslims followed him.
All the Muslims they followed. Yes. Yeah.
And all the idols.
All the idol worshippers.
Who were presented.
Yes.
Prostrated
him. Yeah.
Oh, it all goes and then Umar is upset. And
that's
then
right.
Umar upset.
That's
Abu Bakr
right.
is upset.
Upset.
Is upset.
Yes.
And then this is what happens at the end.
Mm-hmm.
Gabriel said, as for this, I did not bring, it is from the devil. And so Allah exalted him, revealed the prophet.
So Allah's prophet couldn't understand.
Satan proposed in respect of that which he recited thereof. And Allah abolished in which Satan proposed.
Yes.
Can you respond to the Bible verse?
Muhammad. Hold your horses.
Yeah. He couldn't even recognize them.
First deal with this.
I can't hear you, that's why.
He couldn't even recognize the voice of Satan. Bow down and worship those.
Yeah. Yeah.
Confronted him.
So,
and Muslims did the same. It's not only your prophet is pagan worshiper.
Yeah.
Also made his followers
all the Muslims. All the Muslims. Yes.
How come Muhammad did not even recognize the voice of Satan?
So all the Muslims they worshipped Lat, Manat, Uzat, and Allah.
Okay.
Yeah, Allah.
Anyways,
Allah.
As
yeah.
you guys can see, I've already presented Allah, the sources that have said by consensus.
No. That's the lie about. That's the lie about all Muslims. That's the lie about all Muslims. This is authentic. That's authentic.
Can you let me speak?
Is it better than Tabari?
Can you let me speak?
Is it better than Tabari?
Can you let me speak?
Don't cry.
If you behave
you said
yourself.
I can respond.
Don't,
you cut me off.
Don't cry.
Is it better than Muhammad?
Is it better than Gabriel? Is it better than Allah?
Okay, I don't know if this isn't going through your head. This is a fabricated report. I quoted to you two sources.
By Muhammad.
Wait,
yeah.
Let me speak.
Yeah, by Muhammad. Fabricated by Muhammad.
Right? They were later fabricated.
Yeah.
You quoted to me one fringe opinion. I quoted to you two scholars, and there's more that I agree
she,
with.
She read three. She read
on
three.
On top of that,
she read three.
Paul was tortured by Satan in 2 Corinthians. Can you respond to
me? She read three.
Why was Paul tortured by Satan?
I will deal with that.
Okay, deal with it. Deal with it now.
Get
can you deal with it?
I gave you Ibn Ishaq. Have you got anything before Ibn Ishaq you can give me? I gave you Tabari, 6107.
Yeah.
Have you got anything before Tabari you can give it to me?
Yeah.
I gave you Tafsir, Asab and Nuzul.
Yeah.
Have you got anything before him you can give me?
Nothing.
Have you got anything before those three individuals tells you it is in public?
Yeah. Yeah.
Anyways, I gave my scholarship. I'm not making this up.
No, I
gave my scholarship.
No.
You've been deceived.
You are deceiving.
I quoted verbatim. I quoted Al-Qurtubi.
No.
Do you know who Al-Qurtubi is?
What is their date?
Do you know who Al-Qurtubi is?
What is their date?
Do you know who Al-Qurtubi is?
I know. Okay. What is their date?
Which date? You're running away from the question. You need to address Second Corinthians. You haven't addressed that. Can you address that, please?
No. Don't run away. When
you
is he written?
Why are you
so here's
from?
The problem.
Why are you running away from?
Let me explain why I am running away. Here's the problem.
Okay, why are you running away, Hatsun?
I gave you three sources, and then I asked if they are fabricated. There must be something before those three sources tells you that they've been fabricated.
Where did you get that from?
So,
can you call any
I gave you Ibn Ishaq. I gave you Tabari and then I gave you the Tafsir. Listen, why are you cutting? Why are you cutting now? Why are you crying now?
So,
can you let us speak?
And in this, I gave you Muhammad, I gave you Gabriel, and you've got better scholar than them. That is already disturbing. But if you are going to butcher this, where Muhammad doesn't even know the voice of Gabriel, bows down and worship the idols alongside all Muslims. Not only he commits shirk, but also he takes people to commit shirk. You need to show me something before Ibn Ishaq, before Tabari. Please bring your reference, okay? Qurtubi, Ibn Kathir, they are way after Tabari, and your scholars already telling us, actually, yep, they are way after Ibn Ishaq and after Tabari. So, have you got a source to clean up your mess of your prophet?
So, I don't know where you've got this premise from. I need you to quote me a scholar that says all of the earliest sources are the most reliable. We know this is false through the method of Jarh wa Ta'dil. Have you studied Jarh wa Ta'dil?
Quran is not reliable.
No one is with you on this, right? You're pulling these premises out of your backside. I don't know where you got these rules from. Magic Sahih rules from Hatun. Where did you get these magic Hatun rules?
I'm asking you a question.
Why haven't you addressed the Bible? Why haven't you addressed the Bible? Second Corinthians. Paul was being deceived and attacked by Satan. Tortured by Satan. Why haven't you addressed that? She's silent. She doesn't want to defend her Bible. She doesn't want to defend her Bible.
Stop crying.
Why are you defending your Bible?
Stop crying. I'm gonna.
You guys aren't defending your Bible.
You see what she responds to that?
Yeah.
It's supposed to be a good debate.
No, you took to see her. There's not even a doubt. Everyone can see.
Who is this crying baby behind his mother's skirt? So now let me deal with that. So now we identified there is no source before Ibn Ishaq. There is no source before Tabari. What we have is crying Muslims simply try to justify that. So that's that.
I brought my scholarship. Who are your scholarship?
Give him a chance to wrap up.
Hatun's running, thank you. I quoted the scholarship. I quoted a verse of the Bible where Paul was tormented by Satan. She doesn't want to address it. Running, why are you running? Okay, number two. Yeah, no, I'm doing a summary, I'm gone.
You are giving the content.
I'll leave out the
police, Shaq, say.
Now he's taking the Muslim away.
I'll take it away.
Yeah. Sharia police is at speaker's corner. I am gonna bring a baby who is running away from now on.
Yes.
Crying baby is gonna come and run away from speaker's corner. Here's the thing. Islamic sources Islamic sources explains to us Muhammad did not recognize, brother, and I correct. Islamic sources express to us Muhammad did not recognize the voice of Shaitan.
That's right.
Therefore, he thought it was the voice of Gabriel.
Yeah.
He bowed down and worshipped these pagan gods.
That's right.
Allah gave him a comfort, like a cuddling blanket. Oh, Muhammad, it's gonna be okay. I will forgive you. All you did was you and your followers to worship the pagan gods. It will be okay. That's what Allah did. Muslims need to provide reference. Before Ibn Ishaq, before Tabari, simply says those sources are not reliable. Not 21st century scholars who goes back and looks at the Qurtubi and Tabari. Not them, but before them. That's how it works. And Muslims express...
So what's the point of abrogating afterward?
Yeah.
Afterward, abrogating the verses, it should be stopped before even they bow.
Pardon? Yeah.
Bow down.
Yeah? A man of God worships the pagans and encourages all of his ummah to worship the pagan gods.
Yeah.
Should be Muhammad should be sliced and then given to the dogs.
That's right.
What was the reference he was asking?
First Corinthians something.
What was the reference he was asking? Anyone remembers?
2 Corinthians chapter 12, verses 6 to 7.
And if I should choose to boast, I would not be fool, because I would be speaking the truth. But I refrain, so no one will think of me than a warrant by what I do and say, to keep him from me becoming conceit because of the surpassingly great revelation that was given me, a thorn in flesh, a messenger of Satan, and torment to me. What is the problem with this verse? I've got no problem.
What was his argument on that passage?
He was trying to justify how Muhammad worshipped the pagan gods, and then he used Paul to justify that. Paul, man of God. Paul, man of God. Muhammad can't even tie his shoes up. Muhammad can't even tie his shoes up. Paul is not saying, I am receiving this revelation from Satan at all. Paul is saying, these worldly things are taking me away, but I will stuck with the Lord. God bless you all. Turn to Lord Jesus Christ.